Follow up now to an exclusive interview with Leila Fowler's father. One of the key witnesses we still haven't heard from yet in Leila's death would be her brother, who's accused of killing her. But during his interview with KCRA3's Mike TeSelle, Fowler's dad opened up about what his son thinks about the charges against him.
I want the truth. I want whoever did it to be held accountable.
In his first interview since his daughter, Leila Fowler's death, Barney Fowler answered my questions about the person suspected in her death. The suspect is Fowler's 12-year-old son, Layla's brother, seen here at a community vigil for his sister. He's accused in connection to the killing that took place inside this Valley Springs home.
He's been in jail for 93 days.
Fowler, sitting with his fiance and his oldest son, told me that since his son's arrest, he's made the most of limited contact.
I see him 2 times a week, and I get to talk to him on a third time on a phone call.
I asked him, how is his son doing in juvenile hall?
He has his days where it's bad. We don't talk about the case. We don't talk about, we just kind of go in and talk about normal kid stuff, what he did that day. He is in the school, what he ate. They make him get up. They exercise. They get to watch movies. They get their rec time, playing basketball. He's being a normal 12-year-old in a juvenile hall facility. I mean, he's got a couple of people in there that he talks to, and luckily he's in a small juvenile hall and it's not a lot of chaos.
This father also relayed how his son feels about the charges against him.
I'm just very confident in there. Confident he'll be out soon.
You believe in Isaiah's innocence, right?
Yes.
What kind of parents would we be if we didn't believe in him?
If I turned my back on him right now and he's innocent, how much more would that hurt him? Right or wrong, I've always stood by my children.
One child, a 12-year-old son, accused in the death of another child, his own sister. In San Joaquin County, Mike TeSelle, KCRA 3 News.
Fowler also said that he would be allowed more calls with his son in juvenile hall if he had a permanent address. However, as Mike found out, this family hasn't been able to find anybody out there willing to rent them a new place, partly because of questions about Barney Fowler's character. We'll have more on that part of this exclusive interview. It's coming up tonight on the news at 6.